everyone, and welcome to CFC Fan TV. This is a brand new video. I hope you're all enjoying your Sunday, but we think you're going to enjoy it. We're still outside the bridge, even though you lot are probably at home by now. Well, I'd hope so anyway.
I hope I'm home by now.
It's been a while. Anyway, we think you're going to love it, so do comment below and let us know what you think of this video. It is CFC Fan TV's Player of the Year. Now, in order to do that, we need to come up with a chart for the whole of the season.
Like
and
it.
Yeah, so every game, we are going to vote for our Man of the Match, and there's going to be three players in contention for this. So we picked three that we think stood out for us today, and at the end of it, we are going to vote. So, shall we get going?
Chelsea!
Okay, so our three players are now on the screen. We have gone for Eden Hazard, David Luiz, and Jorginho.
Yeah.
Again, not to take credit away from any other players, because some of them were fantastic, everyone was fantastic, but we had to choose three that we thought stood out for us today.
Yeah.
Let's start off with our main man, Eden Hazard.
Fantastic today, fantastic in midweek. He's kind of got Liverpool's number a little bit, isn't he?
Yeah.
He always scores against Liverpool. Fantastic goal at Anfield. I actually kind of did, at the Mail at work, I kind of listed his top five ever goals, and I put the Anfield one second behind the one here against Arsenal when we won the league.
Yeah.
But again, he was fantastic today.
Yeah.
I think he's been given a lot more license to kind of be really kind of prolific, and I think that's kind of what's been separating him from the very, very top players in the world.
Yeah,
and
sure.
So it's great to see the next stage of that. And he's been fantastic.
There's no way that he couldn't have been in contention for Man of the Match for this game, because I mean, let's face
I get the feeling as we do this feature going forward, we're going to be talking about Eden Hazard a hell of a lot.
Well, you say you think it's going to be his best ever season, so there will definitely be a few more votes for him.
Yeah.
Anyway, now, but you know what? I think from the get-go today, Liverpool knew, certainly Jurgen Klopp knew, they were going to need to close him down a hell of a lot. And they did try, and in the first half they failed because he was just unstoppable. He was too good for them. And again, he got us our goal. Goes and celebrates from the Liverpool fans as he loves that, doesn't he?
He loves doing that, and it's one of my favourite things. I remember when we drew 2-2 against Tottenham here to stop them winning the league, he went right up to their fans.
He just loves it, doesn't he?
I love him forever for that.
But you know what? Yeah, like I say, his all-round play, his goals, he gets back, he did a little few bits of defensive work today. So, you know, there's no way we couldn't have been talking about Eden Hazard for this video. So he is definitely in contention. Shall we move on to our next one?
Let's go.
Next up, as you can see on screen, is David Luiz. Now, David Luiz today, I want to start by saying I've been very critical of him. Sometimes, obviously, it's not fair. And I just have to say today, I thought he was fantastic, and there's no way we could not be talking about him. He kicked the ball off the line. I thought that was a goal. I thought Liverpool were going to equalise, and he stopped that from happening. He was getting the crowd going, asking us a cheer. I mean, this was towards Shadow, because that's where I sit, fuming every time we give away a free kick. Not just necessarily him, he was shouting at his teammates. And although I know you don't want to see them arguing, but that shows passion in a game.
Yeah, of course.
And he really, really cared today, and he really, really wanted to win.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's what David Luiz brings you. And I think it was...
He's a bit of a leader today.
Yeah. Well, I think that's why he's in the team, Soph. And, you know, I think that it was reminiscent of his very best performances for Chelsea.
One of his best performances so far this season for me.
Oh, by a mile.
Yeah.
By an absolute mile. He stood up and was counted today. It was our biggest game of the season so far. And, you know, if he's going to play like that against Liverpool, if he's going to play like that against Man City and Man United and Tottenham, then it's worth having him in the team.
Yeah.
You know, yes, he's been... There's been time to criticise.
There are times when he gets a little bit too excited.
Yeah.
Again, where he obviously cares too much
and does
give away the odd foul. But again, I don't want to say anything negative about him today, because I really think he kept us in the game for quite a lot of that.
He was brilliant. It was like watching him in Conte's first season. When he was in the middle of that back three and he was so good. And he was brilliant today. And it was
and it's
kind
good
of
to see that he's actually settled back in so quickly and working well with Rudiger.
Yeah. They're becoming a very good partnership, and I can understand so far this season a lot of people have said, well, why don't we try Christensen or whatever else. But I think today it was a big game for him, and he needed one of these games.
Yeah.
I think because I mean, for me, when I've been talking about Chelsea to people at work or whatever, I've kind of said, well, Luiz might be the one to kind of slip out of the team.
Mm-hmm.
But he needed a big performance today, and he delivered massively. So
it's a huge game for us, and I said, I thought he handled the pressure well. I thought he directed other players very well. You could see how emotional he was getting at times, especially in the second half. And there's no way where he couldn't be in contention, so he obviously also is up there in contention to win Match of the Match. Man of the Match.
Let's go, Marcel.
I know. Okay, and then we're going to talk about our last player. So We have to talk. There was quite a few in contention for this because it was very hard for us to pick three today. Because for the majority of the game, it was so good. Yeah, and collectively, it's very hard to talk about individual players today because I thought collectively as a team, we were also very, very good. Which obviously isn't always the case. We have gone for Jorginho. I've taken into consideration what the fans said in the fan cams. They also are full of praise for Jorginho. I think he settled in so quickly, and I think today he really held his own. He offers something in that midfield that we haven't had for such a long time. In such a big game like this, to not make an error that I can visibly see is quite a big deal.
Well, he's so crucial to this system. I got a lot of abuse on Twitter.
The system, yes.
I got a lot of abuse on Twitter last week because I said... I always do. No, I'm kidding. No. It's because I said he wasn't very good against West Ham, which I maintain that he wasn't very good against West Ham. But the whole point was that he didn't play well, so Chelsea didn't play well.
Right.
You know, and he's so crucial to the system. He was fantastic today, and Chelsea were fantastic today. You know, Sarri brought him in from Napoli. He was crucial to Sarri's system at Napoli. He's crucial to Sarri's system here.
And again, he's one of those players that in order to play a fantastic game, it doesn't necessarily mean scoring a goal. What he does in that midfield area is more than enough.
He's not a goal scorer, and he's, even though he's the deepest midfield position, he's not necessarily a defensive player. I've been a little bit worried about this game and how our midfield setup was going to work. But I thought he was fantastic today, and I thought we controlled the pace of the game very well.
He was the main factor,
and I thought we played like the home side. We took initiative. It's obviously heartbreaking that we conceded such a good goal right at the end. I said a bit more than that at the time and all. I thought the whole midfield played well, and I thought Jorginho was emblematic of that.
So he is our last player. We are now gonna quietly discuss and then vote for who we think gets today's man of the match. Okay, after much deliberation, and believe me, it was difficult.
You were angry about this.
Yes, I was very angry about this, but it takes nothing away from Eden Hazard's goal, but today's man of the match is going to go to David Luiz. So here is the chart now on screen. I've just done a little swipe up for you, so there it appears.
Do it again, Sophie. One, two, three.
Oh, there it goes. So there you go. There's our chart, and obviously David Luiz gets the first star of the season. Again, that was a really tough one, I felt. Tough decision to make.
No, it was. It was a very good team performance. We were very unlucky not to win. The whole team played very well. And I just thought that Luiz, you know, it's a little bit harsh on Hazard, but Hazard stands out every week. And David Luiz, I thought, just really stood out today. I was delighted with his performance, and I'm happy to give him man of the match.
Okay, so to David Luiz is our man of the match for Chelsea versus Liverpool, which ended in 1-1. Guys, look out for it next week against Southampton, because we're going to let you guys vote. So we're going to tweet it out. We're going to choose our three players, and we're going to let you guys vote on who you want for the man of the match. Yeah, of course, exactly. So we want to get you involved in this as much as possible. So comment below, what do you think? And please feel free to disagree with us on this one. I'm sure there'll be quite a few in contention for this, won't there?
We'll get a load of abuse.
Anyway, we're all going home now. We're tired.
Thank God for that.
See you guys. Thank you.